In this video lecture, we're going to discuss a couple ways to control the appearance and formatting of output data in Java programs. Okay, let's get started. So up to this point, we've seen how to provide user output from our programs, either to the screen or to a pop-up GUI dialog. But sometimes, we will also have the need to format the appearance of our output data. Here's a simple example to show what we mean and to motivate the discussion that follows. Take a look at the simple source code on the right, which calculates miles per gallon, given input miles in gallons, for two different data sets. Miles per gallon, of course, is a simple division of the miles traveled divided by the gallons consumed. Here we've just gone ahead and declared all of our data to be of the double data type, so we don't need to worry about any casting in this calculation. When we have nice, simple, round numbers such as these, the output miles per gallon is very nicely formatted, as we see down here in the first output. But when the input values are a bit less perfect and more realistic, as we see here for the second set of inputs, then the resulting calculation is going to look more like this, with lots of excessive decimal accuracy that, quite frankly, we don't want to see displayed. Practically speaking, no neighbor or ad is ever going to brag about their car getting 31.712582, etc. miles per gallon. So now the question becomes, how can we truncate the display of such data for output reporting purposes without affecting the numerical accuracy or the values of the data itself? In the material which follows, we'll take a look at some ways of doing this. Please take a moment now to pause this video and view the short code walkthrough video for formatsneeded.java, where we'll see this file executed. It's pretty short. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along. You'll find this example in the usual place. Come back to this video when you are finished. It turns out that we have multiple options available to us for controlling the format of output data. What all of these have in common is that they all involve the setting up of some kind of template or data mask, or more specifically, a format specifier, which is used to display the data. You can think of the format specifier as a type of lens through which we view the data without actually altering it. These first two options, decimal format and number format, are both Java classes found in the java.txt package, which can be used to format output data. These were covered by a prior textbook I used to use for this course, but they aren't covered in the current textbook, so I've chosen not to emphasize them here. Nonetheless, they are listed here for the sake of completeness, and you can take a look at them in the Java API if you're curious. The formatter class, found in the java.util package, is a bit more central to our current discussion. Although we won't cover the formatter class specifically, its Java API does very thoroughly document the notion of format specifier strings, which we will go over shortly. We'll only cover a small portion of what's available to us in terms of format specifiers, but those will be the most common and useful features for our purposes. When you have a chance, I encourage you to take a quick look at the formatter class API to get an idea of the breadth of capability available to us in format specifiers. These last two options in blue are the ones we'll focus on in this lecture module. The first one is the System.out.printf print command, another alternative to the usual println, which allows us to print some comma-separated list of output variables according to some user-specified format specifier string. The second one is the format method, which is a static method of the string class, so it is called using the name of the class itself, as shown here. String.format is similar to this other one, except that it actually returns a similarly formatted output string without actually printing it. And this string can be used however we wish, including printing it out, or perhaps simply utilizing it for some other purpose. In both cases, however, notice that a format specifier string of some sort is common to both these methods. This table shows the usage APIs for both of the output formatting methods we'll be considering. Unlike such tables for prior APIs, note that these two methods are not from the same class. One is from System and one is from String, but they are presented together here so that we may compare and contrast them. Also, note that because both of these are from standard Java classes that are part of the java.lang package, there is no need for any import statements when we use these. We get to use them with no such overhead. The key distinction between these two methods is that printf prints the formatted string using the provided format specification, while format returns a formatted string using the provided format specification. So printf is a void method, meaning that it returns nothing to its caller, while format is a string method, meaning that it returns a string to its caller, though it does no actual printing on its own. If you are familiar with C or any of the C-like languages, printf is directly patterned after C's identical printf command. I imagine this was done with the intent of making it easy for C programmers to port their programs over to Java. Both printf and format are alike in that each method can handle a comma-separated list of output variables, which is indicated by this args list in each one's interface. The key thing to note here is that there must be a one-to-one correspondence between the list of variables to be printed out and the ordered elements of the format specifier string. Let's take a look next at specifically what we mean by format specifiers. Format specifiers are nothing but short, specific text patterns describing how some output data is to be displayed. You'll find full documentation on format specifiers as part of the Java API for the formatter class, and I encourage you to take a browse at that to get an idea of the extent of what's available. In this table on the right, we are simply excerpting examples of the most common and useful elements for this course. You'll notice that each of these format specifiers on the right is simply a short text string within double quotes, and they all incorporate this percent symbol as the leading character. For our purposes, the most common data types will be these first three: %d for integer or whole numbered values, such as ints or longs. By the way, don't get that d confused as a mnemonic for decimal point, because it's not. It really refers to a decimal number. %f for floating point data, such as doubles or floats, and %s for strings. These are the simplest forms of format specifiers for these data types. But then beyond that, we can also specify other output display attributes. For example, field width and justification. In this next example, %5d, this will be some integer value displayed in a 5-width field and right justified by default. But this next %-5d will be the same thing, only left justified, because this dash prefix indicates left justification. We can also control the width and the number of displayed decimal places for floating point values. For this next example, %8f, this will display a floating point value with an 8-width field, but this %8.2f format refines that by truncating any decimal accuracy to at most 2 decimal places. So this would be the type of format specifier we'd want to chop off any excessive numerical accuracy arising from calculations. However, when you're determining a field width together with a maximum number of decimal places, keep in mind that the decimal point consumes one place of that field width. We can also control things like leading zeros and separation. In these next two examples, this format %08d with a leading zero would display some integer value in an 8-width field, but now zero padded on the left. Similarly, this leading comma in the %8d format would display some integer value in an 8-width field, but it would also add the traditional locale-specific 3-place comma separation, which can be useful for large numbers or currency expressions. Finally, we can also apply these types of formatting to strings. This last example format specifier, %-20s, would display some string in a 20-width field, but left justified. So in all of this, you can see that we now have the capability to nicely arrange and organize our outputs into neat columns, if that is needed. Note that we aren't confined to using just short, simple format specifiers such as these. In fact, we can incorporate such format specifiers into larger formatting strings and surround the actual data display with other useful things, such as text labels, currency symbols, perhaps incorporating special Unicode characters, the units of the data, and even control characters such as tabs and new lines. Again, there is much more to format specifiers than we can cover in this short treatment. There is also handling available for things like dates and times, exponential notation, binary numbers, and many other things. Do take a short glance at the Formatter API to get a quick overview of what can be done with format specifiers. The final important point I want to make is this. Format specifiers only change the output appearance of the data. They do not alter the data itself. It's similar to formatting in a word processor. Whether some text is bold or italic is immaterial. The content of what you've written is unchanged. Only its appearance has been changed by its formatting. For those of you having some web design experience, you can make a similar analogy between HTML for content and CSS for styling. Okay, Having said all this, let's take a look at some examples using format specifiers. Here is the first half of an example file which demonstrates the use of format specifiers. This code is explained in greater detail in the code walkthrough video for formatspecifiers.java found in the usual place, so I encourage you to view that video while you follow along in JGrasp. Nonetheless, here is an initial overview of this example. In this example, we're setting up some int, double, and string variables and then printing them out using both printf and format. Each method requires some type of format specifier, which I've highlighted in yellow to make more apparent. Note that the printf format specifiers incorporate some labeling text, but the format ones do not. They just have these simple forms. In terms of the actual printing, remember that printf actually performs the printing itself, but it won't kick the output down to the next line like println does, so we need to incorporate a new line control character in each one, as we see here and here. By contrast, format by itself doesn't print anything, so these entire expressions resolve to one string themselves, which is then string concatenated with some labeling text, and then this entire string expression is printed out using println as usual. Down here at the bottom are the resulting outputs, and you can see they are identical between the two ways of printing. Let's continue on to the remainder of this example. This is the remainder of the prior example, and again here, the format specification strings are highlighted for clarity, but now the format specifiers themselves, which here are underlined in red, are embedded within larger strings. So in this next set of examples, we're simply printing the same piece of int data with four different formats, with the output shown at right. Right aligned by default, left aligned due to this leading dash character, three place comma separated due to this leading comma, and zero padded due to this leading zero. In all cases, the surrounding labeling text is incorporated within these format specifier strings. And notice also that each one contains an embedded newline character, because printf won't do that for us. The next two examples show that we can have multiple data arguments, as long as there is a one-to-one correspondence between each variable and its format specifier. Once again, notice that string.format simply returns one formatted string, so this entire expression is one string, and we pass it along to println for the actual printing, since println just displays whatever it's told. In the corresponding output on the right, notice that this line comes from this format specifier, but these next two lines of output are the result of this second format specifier, which in turn has this new line embedded within it, which causes the output to span two lines. But still, there is a one-to-one correspondence between each piece of data to be output and a corresponding format specifier. Finally, in this last section, we're simply printing out the same Hello World string in three different ways. The first line is left justified due to this leading dash. The second one is the normal default right justified. And then this last one is dynamically justified, but identical to the prior one. What I mean by dynamically justified is, rather than hardwiring this 20 in the format specification, we are actually calculating the needed field width from the length of the string and then splicing it into the format specification using string concatenation, as we see here. Either way, the output result is the same. Again, I emphasize that in all cases, the data itself is left unchanged and only its appearance to the screen has been changed. This is analogous to the separation of content and format, such as in a Word document, or between HTML and CSS for a web page. Once again, I encourage you to take a moment now to pause this video and view the code walkthrough video for formatspecifiers.java. Open up this file in JGrasp so you can follow along with the execution. You'll find this example in the usual place. Come back to this video when you are finished. Finally, there's one more example file I want to cover, and that is formats2.java, which you'll find in the usual place. Please open up this file in JGrasp and follow along with a code walkthrough video. This file contains multiple examples of formatting applied to program outputs of more practical calculations, including the setup of format specifier strings to be used elsewhere, batting averages limited to the standard 3 decimal places, prices with and without foreign exchange, limited to 2 decimal places and using 3 place commas, and employee IDs with 0 padding. This example file will show how to do printing in 3 different ways, using the standard System.out.println, which will show data in its rawest form, and using both System.out.printf and String.format to produce formatted output. Make sure that you go over this example because I think it will give a lot of examples and answer a lot of questions about output formatting. And with that, I think we'll conclude this topic.